Hello world, welcome to this DroneLink Advanced Project to VR. In this episode, we're going to demonstrate another way of making an image from mapping. In many of my previous videos, I have demonstrated several kinds of mapping, like orthophoto or equirectangular with a 360 image. In this video, we will demonstrate you how to use Project to VR. This app is not for free, but there is a trial period. This sample shows you the process of Project to VR. You take a number of images in every form you like, and you put them together in like a web page. The big difference is that as a viewer, you have control over what you see. Basically the same as in WebODM, except this is a real image and not a 3D object. We start with two identical orbits on top of each other. I always use 20 degrees overlap. I'll explain why. Because we have a photo interval of 3 seconds, we want to make sure that we have a full 360 degree orbit. So it's better to have a little bit overlap, so we can cut. Because we can take out the first and the last images which might not properly be aligned, we always have spare images. This makes aligning a lot easier. As you can see, it's a normal interval mission with two orbits, 70 centimeters in diameter and 3 seconds difference between every image. Because it's an image setup, we always say that more images is better, so reduce speed and reduce time interval for a smooth image. In this sample, I have two orbits on top of each other, exactly the same, and I am orbiting my car at two different heights, 25 meters and 50 meters. Let's check the preview. That all looks good, so let's take some pictures and start processing. Alright, let's first find our images. Here we have the images. These are all of them, but I'm only interested in the last ones. I usually make a very short movie, maybe 1 second, but just to have a difference between my last batch and the new batch. The first photo is completely misaligned. The second photo is the wrong color grade. But this is the good one, so we start here. We have a total of 63 images per row, but this of course is too much, so we have to find out the correct ones. If I compare number 63 and image number 1, you see that the alignment is not correct, because we have taken more images, so we take the best one and the other ones we take out. I have already cleaned them up, so let's use the correct batch. Here you see the first and the 59th image of the 25 meters, and of course the same for the 50 meters. So each row contains 59 images. This is important. Now we will open Object to VR. We will make a new light table. Columns is, as we said, 59, and rows are 2. Update. My light table is now correctly set, so we can import the images. We will select the first row, which is the top row, and we take the 59 images from 50 meters elevation. The app will import and process the first batch of images. If you take the wrong amount of columns, the program will locate them over there. It works, but it's not good. When the app is finished importing, we can select the second row and do the same thing. Of course, you can make more rows or columns, but I have only two, which is sufficient for this demonstration. All the images are imported now. Here you can set your start position, the images, but normally only row number one. Now this is all set, you see, we go save it as an HTML5, so you can use it as an interactive web page. I always take the highest resolution, all the other settings you have to find out yourself. I want to have the speed as low as possible, so the rotation is smoothly. We activate zoom. And this is the important one. Here you can set your controls for your HTML5 web page. You will see on the page what I mean. Now we save everything. We give it a unique name. And now it will process the web page. And we export. There we go. You can have triangles, you can have squares, or in my case circles or orbits. You can basically have any figure you want. And when done, this is how it looks. You can see in the bottom center the controls. These are really necessary. You can scroll forward or backward, frame by frame. You can go up and down. And then also back, forth and forward. Now we go back to 50 meters, 20 meters, 50. And you can zoom. If you have no overlay, you also can zoom and pan around with your mouse. And we zoom out again. And auto-rotate. You can see it's still much too fast. But you get the idea. So, if you have an interactive image like this from, for example, a building site, your contractor can have frame by frame look to the progress.